Hi and welcome to this Bitwig Basics episode. In this video we will talk about the device browsers of Bitwig Studio. My name is Mattias and let's go! Okay, so the device browsers of Bitwig Studio. If we open a blank project in Bitwig and press the plus sign here in the arrangement view, we can create a new track. Or, as I told you in the previous video, we can press Command and T to add a new instrument track. I drag this into a group. I have this group only for my special routing. You don't have to have this group in your projects. And so we have an empty instrument track. If we go down to the bottom of the screen, where we have the Devices panel, if you don't have it, you can press the D button on your keyboard to bring the device panel up, and you will see this plus sign again. If we press this plus sign, we will bring up the devices panel. And this is the browser from where you add plugins and devices to your tracks. You can see at the top here we have a search bar, which means that we can search for specific plugins or presets from Bitwig or from third-party developers. You can see that I've written piano, and then we can see that we have 99 plus presets that refers to the piano text. And then we have multi-samples, which is samplers with multiple samples. And we have an acoustic piano that we can load up. And we also have separate samples, 99 plus. It's probably quite many in here. And you can also preview the samples directly from this browser. But let's load up this acoustic piano from Nectar. And then it loads up this piano device or piano sampler for us on this track. If we want to go back and load another plugin instead, we can just press the folder icon here, which brings up the browser again. And we can select the grand piano maybe instead. You can see as soon as I select another plugin up here in the browser, it will load it at the bottom of the screen on the track. Yeah, so now we have a piano. And let's go back to the browser again. You can see if we go into this first tab, which lists devices, which basically is plugins and instrument devices of Bitwig. Depending on what you've selected at the bottom of the screen here in the browser, you can select either audio effects, which will only list effects, VST effects and Bitwig effects, or you can select instrument, which will only list your third-party instruments and the Bitwig instruments. And the note effects, which is MIDI and some other note-related effects. Okay, let's go up to instrument again. You can see that we have the drum machine of Bitwig and a few electronic instruments available from the Bitwig devices. If we only want to list devices from Bitwig and not from third-party developers, you can easily do this by pressing the Bitwig locations tab up here. And now you can see that we have a cleaner selection, which only shows us the Bitwig devices. So we can load up a polysynth, or maybe the Phase 4. Or the organ. If we go to this next tab, you can see that you also can select a category. Maybe you only want to list the drums of Bitwig, or keyboards, or synths. Now let's activate all devices locations again, so we can see all the instrument plugins of Bitwig. And let's go to this left side of the screen again. You can see that we have some special folders here, and these aren't available from start from When you first install Bitwig, you only have the everything and favorites folders. And then you can add these folders to sort your instrument and effects in Bitwig. You can easily create the collection by pressing the right mouse button and select create new collection. Let's call this My Reverbs. And now you have a new collection folder here. It's currently empty if we select it, but let's go up to everything again. And to be able to list the reverbs and delays, we need to select the audio effects tab down here. So let's go to the audio effects. Let's look at creator and select maybe an effect from Valhalla. Select the Valhalla room and drag it to the My Reverbs folder. Then we can also select, maybe we want the reverb that comes with Zebra in the Zebrify plugin. So let's drag that to My Reverbs too. And now you can more easily access these reverbs from this My Reverbs tab. So if we go back and we have this, piano. Now we can press the plus sign to the right side of this sampler plugin and go to My Reverbs. And now we instantly can select this Valhalla room. It's also possible to hold shift and press the plus sign to bring up the favorites folder directly. And the favorites folder can basically be anything. You can drag the plugins that you want to have easily accessible. Maybe I want the QL spaces and the play instrument. Now, as soon as I press shift and left click, it will take me to this favorites folder. So I can instantly load up maybe the play sampler or something. Yeah, so within this device browser, you can sort by creator. So you can select the specific third-party developer that you want to view. Maybe you only want to view the Isotope plugins or the Melda production plugins or the native instruments plugins. And let's go to presets and select by creator. Maybe go to my folder, Morning Dew Media, and see what kind of presets we have here. Many of these presets are from the Producer Essentials Pack Volume 1, which is available if you press the link down here. It's a specific pack for Bitwig Studio, so go and check it out. Maybe we want to load up this Galvan C64 lead. So the browser is very convenient within Bitwig. And you please also note that if you bring up this browser, let's go to the right side of this plugin, press plus sign. If we go to your effect, it will add this effect instantly to your track, but it will not be applied or accepted. And you can also pre-listen to the sound of this plugin. But if you select cancel here, it will remove it from the track. So also be aware that you need to accept and press OK for this reverb to be added, or this effect to be added to the track. Sometimes you can forget that. Yeah, so I encourage you to sort your instruments and effects in collections within Bitwig, so you swiftly can access them whenever you need them. Create a few folders like this with maybe for delay, distortion, reverb, synths, EQ effects, and modulations. And it will speed up your workflow quite a bit. Yes, and within Bitwig we also have a second browser which is accessible all the time while you're working on your projects. And this is the browser which you have on your right side of the screen. It works the same way as the regular browser. You can just select Browse by Devices, Presets, Samples or Multi-Samples. And here you can just pre-listen to samples and drag and drop to your project as you want. If we drag it to a track, it will create the sampler, but if we rather right-click and create an audio track, and if we drag a sample to the arrangement view, it will only create a sample event on the timeline. So let's create the second audio track for our snare. And maybe program a little beat. Maybe like this. It goes something like this. Maybe find some suitable hi-hat for this. I'm holding down the Alt key while dragging a sample, and it will make a copy of the sample. If you also hold the Shift, you can adjust where to place the sample, which is quite handy. Yeah, so in the browser you can also create the collections as we did in the regular browser. You can go to Devices here and press Collections, and you can see the same arrangement of collections that we saw in the big browser window. So you can go to Reverbs here, and you can also add this to your tracks. Maybe we want to have a little bit of reverb on that snare. So go to the snare track here and just drag the Valhalla room to the track. Yeah, so that's all for the Devices browser of Bitwig Studio. You can shoot me any comments or questions on this video below. Please subscribe and like, and I'll see you in the next Bitwig episode. You can click the card up here. Have a real nice day and see you in the next video. Bye bye!